وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول
الحمد لله رب العالمين له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد. In this introduction, inshallah ta'ala, I want to speak about and I want to talk about becoming happy with when a football team wins. The person gets happy, his football team wins. And they score a goal, they get a prize, whatever it is, he gets happy, he's excited, he goes, yani, he loses control. And I've seen people who've become like that. Yani, they scream, they shout, some even give, you know, yani, money away, just so happy they are. And it's like they've gone crazy. Majnoon, you literally think they're majnoon, they're not sane anymore. The way they scream and they get excited. But if it happens, their team loses, the depression, the sadness, they don't leave their room, they get sad, they get emotional and everything. But that doesn't happen for the religion. If the religion of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala is yani, spoken ill against, if the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is spoken ill against, if a group of Muslims are killed in a particular land or a particular place, if Muslims are suffering in a particular land, yani, and they're harmed and their wealth is taken, and they're caused, you know, pain and suffering, doesn't really bother him. It's concerning. He doesn't feel anything. He doesn't feel that connection towards those Muslims who are suffering around the world. That's not in his heart and mind. If he hears that a mujahideen have fought and won, he doesn't get excited or happy that they defended themselves against the enemies that are yani, transgressing against them. They had no happiness, no joy, no excitement on that person. Doesn't care. Doesn't bother him. He prefers his football team win. That's his biggest yani, joy and happiness. And his depression and sadness is connected to his team losing and not winning. This is haqiqatan a contradiction. It's a clear-cut contradiction. That your allegiance lies in the wrong place. Your love and your passion lies in the wrong place. And we should, as Muslims, look at ourselves and really think and ponder here. Is it right what's happening here? How are we not feeling our Muslim brothers and sisters who are suffering around the world? How is it that we don't feel it? How comes we don't feel pain in our hearts? Did not Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam not say, مَثَلُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ فِي تَوَادِّهِمْ وَتَرَاحُمِّمْ وَتَعَاطُفِهِمْ كَمَثَلِ جَسَدٍ وَاحِدٍ إِذَا اشْتَكَى مِنْ عُضُوٍ تَدَعَى سَائِرَ الْجَسَدِ بِالسَّهْرِ وَالْحُمَّى. الْمُؤْمِنُ لِلْمُؤْمِنِ كَالْبُنْيَانِ يَشُدُّ بَعْضُهُ بَعْضًا. The believers, they're like one body. They feel each other's pain. The Muslim who lives in China and the Muslim who lives in America and the Muslim who lives in Australia and the Muslim who lives in Africa and the Muslim who lives in South Asia, the Muslim who lives in the Middle East and wherever they are in the world, I feel it. Their pain should be my pain. Their joy should be my joy. And that's what I should feel. When they get victorious, I'm happy. When they win, when they lose, I feel sad. But not a non-Muslim, or even if it's a Muslim football team, I get happy about. It affects my day. It even brings a smile to me. Honey, really, is that what someone wants to become or even be like that? This is something, wallahi, we need to think, brothers and sisters. Really think and ponder here. Something's not right. Something is not right. And it's clear what's not right. There's weakness of iman, and it is a sign of yani da'ful iman. Da'ful iman. And it shows a contradiction. It shows a contradiction. The team that you're part of, your team is the Muslim team. That's the team you should support, the Muslim team. And not a non-Muslim team. And it's sad, wallahi, it's really sad. It's really sad that we have callers, supposedly callers to Islam, who yani tell you, I support this team, and I support that team, and I'm with that team. And then they say, They say in the same breath, we care about the Muslims who are suffering around the world. Yani, but you've just told the Muslim amatun nas to love and support a football team and yani, love a football team. and give your full allegiance to a football team, and your happiness and your joy is based on whether they win that game or not, what kind of love have they then got for the remaining Muslims, the Muslim brothers around the world? They don't. So it's you're mentioning, you're calling to two opposing things. Now we should speak the truth in every matter, brothers and sisters. And this is a mistake. A da'i or even a Muslim should not support any of these football teams. Should not support them. The only two team I support are the Muslims. That's the team I support. They're my brothers. They're my sisters. Their pain is my pain. And their joy is my joy. That's my team. I'm with that team. Through thick and thin. As for football team, let them all lose, or you know, let them all drop out of the league. It doesn't bother me the slightest. And that's how we should all think like. I want to spend a split second watching a game that they are playing. Big men who are running after an object that has air in it. What fa'ida does it bring me or you? Or you know, it's sad, wallahi, it's really sad if you really think about it. Is that the people are watching a person who's kicking around something, and whilst he's doing that, he's getting paid, he's getting salary. So he's in his 9-to-5 job, and you miskeen, unemployed Muslim, or even employed, but have more important things in your life, are watching him doing his work, his job, he's doing his job. It's like you're championing and you're cheering for someone who's doing his work, he's doing his job. This is his amal. You're cheering. Where's your amal? Where's your job? Where's your responsibility? You forsake that? It's sad that we used to, in the UK, we used to have lessons in the masajid. And we used to sometimes see Muslims, when there's a football game, they won't come. You won't see them for the football game. They are not in the masajid because there's a football game. إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَىٰ رَاجِعُونَ. They don't come to the masjid, يعني الصلاة. Even بعض طلبة العلم, some students of knowledge. I don't know how they are students of knowledge. But this is the reality. And my statements might sound harsh, but I can't bring the two together personally. I don't know how to bring it together. I don't know how you bring it together, both of them. I'm a student of knowledge. I'm seeking deen of Allah Ta'ala. I'm seeking the Akhirah. I'm taking that path. And here I am on the other side. I support this team. I watch their games. I'm part of that. It's sad, wallahi. It's really sad that we're living at a time like this, where we've, as Muslims, should be focusing on every single thing about our deen and even the dunya. There are things in the dunya that we need to progress in. We need to work towards technology. We need to work towards a lot of things. We don't have time to sleep, brothers. We don't have time to lie down and laugh and joke. We don't have that, wallahi, that luxury we don't have. So it's sad we're just following a people who are setting rules and regulations for us in everything. I recently have been looking into the issue of the vaccine for COVID-19. I've been researching, I've been speaking to, you know, specialists and what they, you know, believe, and, you know, looking at it and just trying to compile a research on this issue. And it's sad that Muslims are not at the forefront on this issue. Muslims are not at the forefront of this issue, whether it be students of knowledge, whether it even be the people who are Muslims in the field of medicine and whatnot. We're not at the forefront. It's a sad reality. So we need Muslims in these areas. We need Muslims who are specialized in these things. So when these problems occur, students of knowledge can go to these people and ask them these questions and get their knowledge and their understanding from these issues. Are we all together, brothers? And not depend fully on the non-Muslims' information and what they pass on to us, brothers. We don't have that luxury, wallahi, to watch games and series on YouTube and this and that, and watch football games and spend our time. We don't have that luxury, wallahi. We need to put our head down. And I'm not saying everybody should be a student of Islamic knowledge. That's good if everybody can. But I'm also saying there are other things Islam does need. We need Muslims who are engineers. We need Muslims who are in medicine. We need Muslims who are in proper, you know, scientific, academic knowledges as well, other than Islam. Studying and learning and getting into these things, we need them. We haven't got time to be watching football, and we don't have time. Wallahi, we don't have that luxury. We don't have that. Aslan is not even luxury, but we don't have time for all of that. Okay, let's focus, let's prioritize, Let's be happy with Islam, the progression of Muslims, the progressions as the religion of Islam being defended. This is where our joy lies. This is where our happiness lies. When a new book comes out that wasn't out before and it's been, it brings us happiness. When we go to our work, as a doctor who's working, as an engineer that's working, as a teacher who's teaching in schools, all of you guys can defend the religion from your place, from your place, from your, you know, hub, from your headquarters you're working from. You defend the religion from there. I remember there was a doctor, subhanAllah, I know I'm going off topic, but there was a doctor that I knew, subhanAllah. And just to show you how if everybody come together, everyone can just give their da'wah from their place in that they're at. One does the da'wah from the masjid, the other one does the da'wah from the streets. The other one is doing da'wah from the schools, another one is doing da'wah from the hospitals. Everyone's working together to build the community and nurture the people. There was a doctor I knew, subhanAllah, people would come to this doctor. And you know, some people, they have this ta'weez on their hands and they've got things on their hands and they believe this is going to give them cure. And one of the things he does is he cuts that from their hands. He tells them about relying on Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, and he tells them this is not going to work because it's a means that's not proven. It can only be proven from one of two ways. It's either proven in the Sharia, which there's no base for that. Rather, the Sharia condemns wearing ta'weez and wearing these ropes and these things that the people wear, which they think that it's going to bring them cure and health. So there's no shar'i evidence for it. There's no also a tangible, worldly observed, cure for it. So those are the only two ways that it can be affirmed. So he cuts that from them. He tells them, look, cures are taken from either the Qur'an and the Sunnah mentioned it to us, or it's taken from the tajribah and the tajribah of the doctors and the medicine and whatnot. And these are allowed for you. But then again, knowing that it's a means only, the cure is always in Allah's hands. He teaches them things. And because the people are coming to him and they're sick, they listen to him because he's a doctor. They take his advice. So it touched me, man. Really did. I felt it. I was like, subhanAllah. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. Allahu Akbar. He's playing his part in building the community from the hospital. And the other one is building the community from the masjid. And another one is doing it on the streets. He's got a table in the streets and he's giving da'wah. If we were a community like that, focused, head on, challenging the problems of our community, then we wouldn't be in the situation that we're in right now. We wouldn't. We'd be seeing fruits and good outcomes for us and the people around us. But when our children are controlled by television and they're watching movies and they're watching cartoons and they're watching this and they're watching that, honey, وَمَتَى يَبْلُغُ الْبُنْيَانُ تَمَامَهُ إِذَا كُنْتَ تَبْنِيهِ وَغَيْرُكَ يَهْدِمُ. When are you going to reach? When is the building going to be complete? If you're putting bricks on top and then someone's taking the bricks from the bottom, when is it going to get complete? Never. Never. This is probably one of the longest that I've done, I think, on the contradiction, because I went off topic. I really went off topic. But I just wanted to speak to you guys all from my heart. Anything which I have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and Shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدي أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. How can you do a 2-second action right now that will give you a share of the reward of everything we're doing on this YouTube channel? Simple. Like this video and click subscribe. Why? It will allow YouTube to recommend our videos to other users. And imagine the huge amount of reward that could be waiting for you on the Day of Judgment if you did that with a sincere intention of spreading the Deen of Allah. You'll be rewarded for every single person who benefits from one of our videos as a result of your like or subscribe. That's an easy 2-second action that you definitely don't want to miss out on. Do it now, click like and subscribe, and don't forget to make that intention.